India's Supreme Court has delivered a landmark verdict on the long-running Cauvery river water dispute. The two neighbors, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, have been at loggerheads over water sharing. The crux of the verdict is that the Supreme Court has reduced Tamil Nadu's share of water and allocated a bigger share to Karnataka. Why has it done that? To ensure drinking water for the city of Bengaluru. There's much more to the balanced judgment from the Supreme Court, including its core message, the river belongs to no one. Jessica Taneja in Delhi and Nishchita Virendra in Bengaluru with this report.
It's a dispute that has lasted over 120 years. The two neighboring states of Tamil Nadu and Karnataka have been at loggerheads over sharing the water of the river Cauvery that flows through the southern states. Now, in a landmark verdict, India's Supreme Court has settled the matter. The crux of the verdict is this. Karnataka has been asked to release 177.25 thousand million cubic feet of water to Tamil Nadu instead of 192. This means that Karnataka gets to keep around 14 TMC of extra river water.
The Karnataka has a special reason to be happy because our liability has been reduced by 14.25 TMC. The drinking water requirement of Bangalore has been fully protected.
The Cauvery verdict was delivered by a three-judge bench of the Supreme Court, which included the Chief Justice of India, Deepak Mishra. The Supreme Court called Karnataka more deserving of additional waters, noting that the state has limited access, even though it's an upper riparian state. The most significant part of the judgment was the fact that the river belongs to no one and the waters need to be shared.
The key to the decision is the Supreme Court's acknowledgement of Bengaluru's water needs. The top court has prioritized its need for drinking water and referred to it as a global city. It has allotted 4.75 TMC for Bengaluru's drinking water out of Karnataka's increased share.
I think this paves the way, it sets the tone for interstate river disputes that are going to be increasing because we are having severe shortage of water all across. It'll also force states now to look at water conservation in a larger way and try to use their water in a more responsible way. I would say apart from sharing, each state needs to do much more to ensure that they conserve water and have appropriate incentives that people and citizens are incentivized to use their water very judiciously.
While Karnataka has been rejoicing the verdict, the real winner in this case seems to be the city of Bengaluru. Bengaluru has largely been ignored when it comes to the Cauvery water dispute, considering the agrarian issues that have been at the heart of the interstate matter. Now, with the additional 4.75 TMC allotted especially for drinking water needs of the regions around the Cauvery basin, it goes on to show that the Supreme Court has given priority to access to clean drinking water over irrigation needs.
The issue of water is crucial to the states of Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, both in terms of its availability for farmers as well as for drinking. The court has offered a solution to Tamil Nadu's water requirements, even as it's reduced its share, saying the state's irrigation area had not been assessed properly. Tamil Nadu has been allowed to draw half the 20 TMC groundwater beneath the Cauvery basin. But many disappointed farmers in Tamil Nadu said the cut in the state's share of water would reduce cultivation by 1 lakh acres.
Now the Supreme Court has taken review that in view of the fact that groundwater level is available in Tamil Nadu and also Bangalore city is requiring the water for drinking purposes. Now they have reduced the quantum awarded by the tribunal. So now in the entire judgment will be studied by the state of Tamil Nadu. And appropriate steps will be taken. At the same time, we are requesting the central government also to do the needful to provide water to the Tamil Nadu farmers.
Though the verdict is out, its political impact will be felt in the coming days, with the Karnataka state elections just round the corner. Bureau report, WION.